Well, as some appliances age, they can go through a period of high energy consumption. Lately, I've noticed that this fridge always seems to be on, at least anecdotally, when I come in the room. Now, at the urging of my wife, who wants a new fridge, I've decided to show you how to do an energy consumption analysis. Before you let the legs down, you should be sure the balance of the fridge is correct, because you want to reproduce those findings. It should be totally balanced left to right, but the fridge should be tipped back just a tad so that the door easily closes. The first step is to remove the plastic grill and vacuum dust from the condenser coils. That effort in itself can dramatically improve energy cost. In this fridge, I use a pry bar to lift the fridge off its balancing legs, which allows me to spin the legs up so it weighs entirely on the front wheels. Then roll the fridge out to get at the plug connections in the back. Okay, the device we're going to use for this analysis is called the Kilowatt P4460. And this is not a sponsored video, but I recommend a device something like this. To me, this is the ideal one in my situation. It's worth about $50. And we're going to keep it in line with the fridge plug. And so because it's in line, it makes a lot of sense to have two extension cords. This extension cord goes to the fridge, and this extension cord goes to the wall. And that way you can push the fridge back out of the way, and so it's not interfering with the family's day-to-day business over the next couple of days when we do this analysis. Now, one of the interesting things about this device is that it has a memory in it, even after you turn it off. And so when you first turn it on, you need to reset it. So I'm going to press this reset button for a few seconds until the reset sign shows. There, it's reset. And then now I have to set in my energy cost for my district, and I pay 14.1 cents per kilowatt hour. So I'm pressing the adjust button. So we're gonna turn that up. Yep, it's going the wrong way. And then we'll save that. And now we're ready to go. So all we have to do now is wait. Now you can see this is the current draw here. Presently we're drawing only 0 amps, but watch what happens when I open the door of the fridge and the lights turn on. There's the fridge main door, and then here's the freezer. And you can see my current usage goes way up because of those lights. And you can scroll down here, that's right now it's consuming 126 watts, even without the compressor going. This is the VA, this is the Hertz, and this is the power factor, which is a fascinating topic in and of itself. Now, the compressor's just turned on, and one of the cool things about having a voltage easily accessible is that you know instantly that with the compressor turning, you've got no significant voltage drop there. And this is our current draw, 1.62 amps at the moment, and that'll gradually slide down to about 1.3 as it gets closer to its state of charge. All right, so here we are 48 hours later. It's been recording for 47 hours and 37 minutes, and this is how much I've paid, 35 cents. For energy for the last 48 hours. That's pretty darn good. Now the computer will also extrapolate to a 1 year usage. If you make the assumption that the last 48 hours is representative, then we're spending about $65 a year to keep this appliance going. That's well within normal limits for a fridge. So I can't argue that this fridge needs to go on the basis of energy consumption. So when refrigeration systems fail, one of the common methods of failure is that they slowly leak freon out. And with that slow leakage results in an increasing inefficiency of the system where it has to spend more and more of the duty cycle doing the job that used to take just a short time. We're really seeing no evidence of that in this system. The second question is whether or not we believe the data. And in fact, I do. I believe the data. One could argue that this system isn't very well adjusted to take into account inrush current, but inrush current is likely not accounting for a big fraction of what we're seeing. So I hope this video helped you out. Thanks for watching.